Now, our flagship product for looking at process data is PI ProcessBook. So as you can imagine, we do have fairly strong integration between ProcessBook and these notifications. So before we take a look, though, let's just take a look at exactly what I'm currently subscribed to, because that's, you know, I don't want to confuse the issue here by what we're really looking at. If I remember correctly, and I'll just go from top to bottom of all my notifications, yeah, I'm logged in as the administrator, and I am subscribed to this CDT warnings. I am subscribed to MyNot1, that was the sample that we created. I am not subscribed to the sample performance equations, and I'm not subscribed to that. So I should be able to see these two show up in my notifications in PI ProcessBook. Now you will notice you can actually go out and find other notifications, even the ones that you're not subscribed to. So ProcessBook is flexible enough to do that. So here's a copy of PI ProcessBook. If you've installed the notifications client, then this, and that's something you're going to have to do on the machine that's running PI ProcessBook. So you do have to install that notifications client. If you recall, that was one of the three things you could choose to install during the installation. So you only have to install that part of it. You go then into View and then Notifications. And this is going to bring up something that should look fairly familiar now. It's that same notifications viewer, the grid that we saw before. And it defaults to showing you my notifications. But as you'll see, you can actually look for notifications that are in other sections, in other elements, or based on other templates, etc. Now notice, this is the list of notifications we are currently subscribed to as the administrator. These are the ones that are recent, the last 2 hours. I can also, of course, look at the ones that are currently active, etc. And then once I look at these, or I've searched for these, then I can choose which one I'd like to see. And you'll notice it actually changes what you're looking at over here in ProcessBook, assigning the start time and end time from that notification to the displays that are up on your screen. So this drills down right into the data that you might be interested in. So that was only a 9 minute long notification. I click on this. This one was 16 hours long. You see we passed the timestamps over here. Now let's look at a couple of other really nice features in terms of just being able to drill down into things. Let's say I'm not looking at any specific displays in ProcessBook. I can actually look at an ad hoc display based on the inputs in the notification. So for example here, I can just do a right click and choose Open Associated Displays. Now what that means, an associated display would be a display that's associated with the notification through that content tab in notifications. Or if there are no displays, look what happens. It just goes out, it finds the trigger. This is the element, or all the element attributes that are referenced in the trigger, and it decides to trend those. And it trends those using whatever time interval is associated with that notification. Yeah, as you can see here as I change. Now that was an example of a notification that didn't have any associated content. But if you recall, we do have a notification that does have some associated content. Let's take a look at how that would work. Okay, first of all, I'm going to need to subscribe to that. That was my other notification, the one called, let's go back and take a look at it. Yeah, that was the one called Status Notification. Now, I'm not currently subscribed to that as the administrator. So what I'd have to do is go ahead and subscribe to it. And I think what I'll do also, just to keep this display clean, I'm going to unsubscribe to this, that CDT warnings. I'll go ahead and check both of these in. And now, down in ProcessBook, all I need to do is search again. So right now, we're finding CDT warnings and MyNot1. But if I retrieve again using that same criteria, you know, click on this search, it's going to find what you're currently subscribing to. And I'm still subscribed to MyNot1, but now I'm subscribed to Status Notification, not that other one, the CDT warnings. Okay, well, let's go back and look at some other options here instead of just my notifications. We can also sort or look at these by the contact. So by contact, what we're talking about is this list of contacts here. You know, I can go out and find notifications that are subscribed or being associated with other contacts. Now, another choice is I can go out and find, if I've implemented categories, I can find these by category, I can find them by template. We haven't really discussed element temp or notification templates yet. We're going to go into that into a different video. Now, the last thing that we can search for is to search by element. And by that, what we mean is you can go into your database, you can go ahead and find any of these, you know, these elements that may have notifications associated with them, and then you'll find all the notifications associated with that element. So in this case, monitor tags, we actually have that one notification called CDT warnings. That is associated with monitor tags. Status notification is not. So when I update this, what we see is, well, the status notification disappears, the CDT warnings reappears, because now we're finding it by this element here. That element that's listed right here, monitor tags. Now I can go out and actually find this for any of the databases. So you're not limited to just the AF database, you know, to one AF database. This will allow us to go out and find any of these AF databases.